Now I will show you how to create this 3D shape using Fusion 360. Start creating the base of that object. So let's save this first file, redesign, file, save, and under exercise 1, rectangular, click save, select create sketch, let's set the origin as this. So let's create a center rectangle, or there are more types for the rectangle. Let's use center rectangle. Use the origin point as your center point. I would like to have a 60 by 100, so just create it first. Then we'll use the dimension. Set this dimension to this line. Say 60. Oh, sorry, let's say 30. I want a 60 dimension. So next, the center to the edge. Let's set it as 50. So now the lines has all turned black, so it's fully defined. Let's click finish sketch, extrude, extend it upwards, use 50. Now we have created the base of the 3D solid object. So now we're going to create another rectangular for this on top of this box. So let's create the top part. Create, select, create sketch. Now it will automatically transfer the plane above the rectangular object. So let's create sketch. Let's set again. Use the rectangular, center rectangular. So here we'll use it. We'll set the dimension. Let's say I want only 10. This side, want at least 50. So it's all turned black, so it's fully defined. Select finish, again, select extrude. Select the object, push it up. I will use around 50. Now we're going to create another object, which is the triangular shape object. To create the triangular shape here, so let's select the X, Y plane, create sketch. From here, we can draw a line, select the end point here, just a little bit above, create another sketch, another edge, and another edge. Close the loop, click OK. Now we can have the dimension pulled in, so let's say here. 10, I'm okay. Let's have this dimension to 10. So let's have the dimension selected from the origin. Okay, so now it turns black. You also need to have the click key. Select the dimensions from here. Click OK. Let's set the dimension from here to here. It's good to have all the profiles to be fully defined. Now it's fully defined. It's all turned black. So we can click finish sketch. Now there's two commands that you can use to either make this solid. First is the extrude. We can have the extrusion both sides. So it's extruding from the center and going to both sides. So let's use distance as 10 mm. Sorry, let's control C and D. I made a mistake. Let's set two sides. Select the distance from one side is 5, then another one 5. So now it's offsetted by 10 mm, 5 mm from one side and the other 5 mm. So 5 mm on the other side. Click OK. Now we have created the shape. You need to mirror this into this part. So let's select the object that we have created. Right click. Now let's mirror this shape to the other side. So just click the last object that we have created. Here, let's select mirror. This display property box will be displayed. Now we'll select the mirror clip. Here, let's use the XY, which is this one. So you can see it already been mirrored to the other side. Click OK. Now we have created the 3D object. Now we're going to smoothen. Let's change the display setting first. View with hidden edges. Shaded with visible edges. Okay, so it's much more nicer, much clearer. Now we're going to use the fillet command using the. Now we are going to continue to smoothen these edges by using the fillet command. You can type F as a shortcut key or select fillet here. Now we're going to select the edges that we want to fillet. So let's move the floating bar. Let's do a paper view first. I would like to smoothen this part, this edge. Let's set up 1 mm. Okay. F again. Select first. Select this part and this part. Let's set it as 1 mm. Click OK. Now you have seen that it's already been smoothened the edges. So let's round off this side internal part. So again, click F in your shortcut key. Select. You have to select all the edges you want to round off at the same time, so you can place the ranges of the filling. So let's say I would like to use here 1.5. Click OK. See, now it looks like it has been welded into this plate. So let's do it on the other side. Again, press F as a shortcut key. Select the edges that you want to fillet. Roll it to the other side. You can select the other side. Here also, I need to set it at 1 mm. Click OK. Press fillet again. You can set these edges. And then this edge, and then the other edge. This is 1.5. So now we have done the smoothen or rounded off the edges. Now we're going to fillet this side. So let's use the fillet again. Use the fillet here. Select. Going to continue to fillet these two edges. So click fillet here, select the edges and the other side. So this one will set it as 10 mm. Now we're going to round at the corner for this. So let's select fillet again, select the 4 edges. Let's set it as 5 mm. Now we have created the 3D object. Now we're going to add in some holes on this top face, protruding downwards. So let's select this face and select the ink sketch. So now we're back to the top part of the rectangular. So let's throw in the circle first. Okay, let's set the dimension. Let's set it as 10. Let's set the dimension from this endpoint to this endpoint, 40, just to make sure that it's fully defined. And activate the 40. Select the dimension from vertically. Now the circle has turned black, so it's fully defined. Okay, press enter. Now we're going to mirror or copy this sketch. So let's select finish sketch first. Now we're going to cut this hole through the object. So let's select extrude. Select the object, which is the circle. Select one side. So then the distance, or you can actually go and zoom in and pull it up through the hole. Then click OK. Now we have created the hole. So here we're going to select this hole and then mirror this one selected. So let's select the mirror plane. One is the XY and then the other one is the YZ. Oh, sorry, let's create XYZ first. Click OK. Now select by pushing control button, both cut hole, and then select mirror. Select the mirror plane. Let's select this XY, oh sorry, XZ. Go back to the selected mirror plane, delete XY. So now it's transferred to the bottom. Click OK. Now we're going to add some materials. Just make sure your mouse pointer is inside the object. Right click, and you can see this appearance box will open. Just open it. Now here is all the different types of metal objects or colors that or materials that we have. When you see this arrow, you need to download. First, click here to download. Here you can just simply apply it, drag and drop. If you want to change, drag and drop. If you want a gold one, let's just drag and drop the gold. So that we then select close. So that is how you apply materials in this 3D object. Now we have completed this, same as our first pictures on the start of the video. So thank you.